where it's Cognitive Gaming taking on Team LoLPro. Hi, I'm Miguel, and joining me here is Studio for what is going to be, I don't think, any aggressive invades, unless LoLPro with Window kind of grouping around mid with them. Nah, never mind, they're going to split up.
There is that 5-point spread. I mean, it's just, it's not a thing you can really do nowadays.
It's standard.
It's just so defensive, it's so safe, and I understand it. I just wish it wasn't the case, because, well, level ones, I think, are funny,
yeah.
At least. I don't want to see a lot of level one kills, because those really snowball games sometimes, but level one engagements are really funny, watching teams like wander through the jungle, not really know what's going on.
Just like, okay, we're going to this brush, then we go to this brush. Oh, we didn't find anybody.
Like, here is our blob. You want to fight their blob in a better way. We don't want us blob versus blob, because who knows what's going to happen there. But if our blob rotates around,
you get a Zac.
Yeah.
There you go.
Let's get blobs.
Ooh, first blood. Drawn right there by Hanser on Rishi Rich. Does hit him with the cleaver.
And Rishi Rich actually responding in chat to that cleaver, not having any fun at all with it.
Second blood. Let's see if he can go for three. Can he go three for three? No, he cannot.
And that's infected. He might actually have to go to the fountain and clean himself off. And actually, that cleaver damage, not going to be that big a deal, but sometimes you do see some of that level one poke matter, especially as creeps do spawn. So if you hit someone at the 130 mark, well, they'll have to take that damage and kind of roll with it. And Richie Rich might go into lane missing 20 or so health. Not a huge difference.
Ooh.
Now he's gonna go in missing a whole lot more, which may not matter that much, but it still definitely takes a little bit of control, a little bit more pressure coming out from Hanser in the first couple minutes of the game.
And he also went Doran's Blade to start on Richie Rich. So no Doran shields for him up there, so not too much regeneration for him. Uh-oh. Elevation Lod, though.
Oh, we saw this last game from LMQ.
He didn't start Q. He started W. So he does have the stun on that Annie, prepped and ready to go. So it could potentially be a little strategy to zone them away early on. We do see the Pillar Priest Picker connect, but that's about it. LOH does eat a missing shot to the face, though, in the exchange. But either way, comes out ahead from the side of LoLPro. As you can see, nothing here in Showa. Sitting all the way back and going to be like that pretty much all lane.
Yeah, nothing here. You can tell he's scared to even get close. That minion wants to get the CS. Does use a mystic shot and actually didn't get it.
Especially with the nerf that actually came to Thresh in the last patch, I think. They reduced his range by 25, so he's 450 instead of 475. So getting even closer to Annie is even more of a nightmare now. While Zamfira poking out Nijaki very hard, abusing that infused passive as well as just the bouncing bombs like crazy against that melee matchup. We do see actually Heaventime coming for the level 2 gang. Zamfira going to be forced to use that barrier flash and satchel to get out. But he does end up surviving, and actually that was a flash from Heaventime to get in for the stun, so good job by him to force out both summoners for Zamfira, and Hijacky still has his own flash, so maybe next gank it will be a kill.
Yeah, that was a really solid initiation onto Zamfira. Yeah,
level
2 gank, it catches them by surprise, but this is already a very, very suspect matchup for Zamfira. It could go much, much worse, so if they start taking control now, if they make it so that by the 4-minute mark, Jackie already has an experience lead, which he'll try and kind of hold the minion wave in mid to try and gain that. It's actually pushing a little bit towards him because of the early harass from Ziggs. That can be huge. And the way Ziggs harasses, especially melee champions, he'll toss out a bomb towards the minion wave. And if the melee champion's nearby getting CS or just trying to defend himself, he's going to take the AoE damage from the bomb, which does have a larger explosion than its hit radius. So it's very, very dangerous for most mid laners. But Jackie, you know, he used it to his advantage and actually got that to deny a lot of experience towards Zamp.
We did have Elise heading towards bot. Zipluck was looking for a gank down there, but decided not to. And kind of not even sticking around. He did golems going towards his raids, going to farm those up and see where he wants to go next. As Heaventime still lurking around that mid lane, kind of hiding around the brush in the blue. We do have pinks coming in on the brush over there. They do see Zipluck, so no surprise to Nijaki as Zipluck maybe heading for a gank down bot. And head behind Lod in LOH. We see the initiation coming from Showa, though. Gets the flay going into Lod for a bunch of damage. Ignites get traded out there, as well as the barrier. And Lod is just getting laid into, and first blood for nothing here with the Mystic Shot coming in. Emerald Ziploc gonna chase down onto LOH, but he just gets the stun prepped, gets out of there. And very interesting play. Lod didn't even burn any summoners in that exchange, as he was just getting laid into by Showa.
I think he knew he was going to die already once the aggressive play started. He must have known Elise was coming. They did actually spot her out. But it really...
That was weird. I feel like he could have netted out, but I guess he didn't want to go for that and just gave it up.
Yeah, like I think he thought he could pick up the kill until Elise showed up, at which point save those summoners and just say, all right, you're going to get away.
Yeah.
Not much you can do about it at this point. It was a very close fight. It's a very odd fight because of the stun and the momentum that comes from whoever gets CC'd. So it almost looked like it was going to be a clean kill for nothing here until that trade in the Annie stun landed. But fortunately, they could not make a hole happen off that. And now Cognitive, they do take a lead. Only 300 gold in their favor, though.
That's not much. Yeah.
not a whole lot of gold. Elise is a little bit behind in CS compared to Pantheon. And it's still very even across the board. As Renekton actually is falling a little bit behind Mundo, but still to pick up all that gold, all those little range minions running towards the tower.
That glorious CS.
Look at him shuffle towards it, just scooting along.
All right, and with that lead in the bot lane now that they have, it's going to be Boots and a Vampiric Scepter for nothing here over Lod with the double Doran's Blade and just potions. So going to be a nice time sustaining, even though they're going to get poked out still very hard. Not caring too much is Lod, though. He does have both of his summoners opposed to the no barrier and ignite from the cognitive bot lane. Do see him poke them out with that Piltover Peacemaker. Going right back to the same position they were last time. But this time, hopefully with more wards.
And this time it looks like LoLPro is going to be going for the aggressive gank. Thresh actually going to be caught out here as, oh, Pantheon doesn't rotate towards bot. Actually goes towards the red buff and
gets the wards out. So
yeah, he's looking for the vision.
Yeah, looking for maybe a counter jungle too, as the red buff will be spawning maybe in about 8.5 minutes because they did start blue for zip block. We do see a repel up top though, going onto Haunter, forcing him to use that sadism, and they're not going to try to even damage through that as they do not have as much damage output this early on. And he's just gaining that health like crazy, 24 health a second. Lod does eat one turret shot for his troubles though, trying to harass out with the Piltover Peacemaker. Back to the harassing game they go.
Unfortunately, the gank on the Haunter was a little bit late. He barely hit level 6, so yeah. that was expected to happen maybe 5 seconds earlier. It would have been a level 5 Mundo, and they would have been able to catch him, probably kill him there, just because the least chase from Renekton Chase is phenomenal. But a level 6 Mundo, that is entirely a different story, and Cognitive very quickly recognizing.
Uh-oh, heaven time. Coming in, does the stun in the satchel charge. He's going to be taking one shot from the turret. Oh, wow. Two shots, and he's down to below half HP with a bouncing bomb, so a ton of damage comes in response. Zamfira is perfectly fine with that. And now that he's level 6, has the Mega Inferno Bomb. There's another dive on a Haunter, though. Force the flash away, slice it and dice it his way in. Not even using Ignite. Oh, there it is. And the Ignite will take down Ziplock. Going to let that one know. It just takes it with the Venomous Bite. I'm like, haha, no kills for you, Richie Rich. That'll be a kill up top. So 2-0 for Cognitive already at 7.5 minutes.
And of course, the flash is burned on Mundo too, so taking the summoner advantage as well. I think towards the end of Ziplock realized, just in case, I'm going to secure this kill, as he had already waited long enough
yes.
to. He was going to feed it, but just for safety's sake, decided not
kill
to.
Kill secured, not kill
and
sold.
Just Cognitive with the outplays. Like, mid lane, that was Zamfir with a very well timed Sample Charge, but denying all of Heaven Time's aggression right there. Normally, you know, you get caught up versus a Pantheon, you're going to get blown up, but because you get so much distance from a Sample Charge, and he timed it well enough to Duke and actually not have
Ooh.
Pantheon follow him.
Ooh.
That stun was worthless. LOH caught out. Can they make something happen off this? Going for different targets, so nothing here takes a lot of damage.
That flay forward ended up getting Lod in a position, not Lod, LOH in a position, to where he just put on the Molten Shield and then stunned it up with the W. So, interesting play out there by Showa. Nothing here. Ate the brunt of that and still has the summoners, though, so not too much of a problem. He'll sustain back up with the Vampire either way. Just forced to use his potion out of that exchange, but the hook connected, and they're still really scared to fight in this bot lane. That Annie pressure and Caitlyn poke is just so strong.
Ezreal did heal back up with potion and that life steal from the Vampire Scepter, and you're right. Like, Annie's not even level 6 yet.
Yeah.
And they're already playing very scared of her, and they really have to. It's just...
It's Ezreal. It's the Ezreal lane.
It's an Ezreal weakness right now, and of course, if Annie gets a stun, it's not just Annie's base damage, but LOD can land a Piltover Peacemaker, and Piltover Peacemaker has incredibly high base damage compared to a lot of other, I'd say, wave-clearing nukes that you'd see in the bot lane. Like, a Piltover Peacemaker right now will probably do about maybe 200-some damage. Combine that with an auto-attack, maybe a headshot proc, and it's very easy for Ezreal to get bursted down right now.
He's got 6% armor pen and 6% spell penetration. We do have a gank coming down, but they do pull in Ziplock, but nothing too big comes off that one. He does end up just backing out after clicking the lantern, so very interesting.
Pink ward cleared, or ward cleared up by Zamfir, trying to keep himself safe. Initiation Oop. By Jackie. Can he get the catch?
Nope. Sassel charge right on out. Perfect counterplay by that one. He actually ended up hitting both of them, so they went in completely opposite directions. We do have the man drop available for Pantheon at this point, so looking for potentially that gank bot lane as Tibbers is up and very soon for LOH. Yes, there he goes, just ding 6. And with a flash, Tibbers and a man drop could be very dangerous, but flashes up for Showa. Uh-oh, here it comes. It's coming right behind them right now. Who is he going to go for? Looks like the son of the Showa. They're going to blow him up and take the easy kill. There it is. The crit comes in from the last auto attack from Heaven Time. I thought they were going to try to pass it over the Lod, but either way, kill secured. And that is going to put them on the board in kills on the side of LOD, on the side of LoPro.
Always important to remember that KS does stand for kill secured. could not stand for anything else. And the solid, that's a solid Pantheon gank. The question is, can you make something happen afterwards? I'd say most games where there is a general Pantheon, you almost always see a kill happen from that level 6 man drop. Like, almost always. It does not happen every now and then, as Ziggs ultimate is used bot lane for that safe clear and that greedy Zamp play. But if they can make something happen off the next Pantheon ultimate, which it does not have the longest cooldown, should be up in about maybe 100 seconds or so.
We got 135.
Yeah, so actually, yeah, about maybe 80, 70 seconds remaining on that cooldown. They can just try and make something happen, like a big dragon play afterwards. If they can catch Zamp in the mid lane, if they catch Ezreal, they could still go for that same style of play. Especially if Elisa is still top lane like she is right now, possibly going for another kill or just a push onto the turret.
Yeah, why not? Snowball Red, I think he's building damage already as is, so we could see that play come through. But with that, they notice that Elisa's top. They're going to give up the tier 1 top turret for the first dragon of the game. So with that turret goal, we'll see actually if they stay in the lead after this dragon does end up falling down. Every time taking it up with Nia Jackie, going to be no problem. Unless the steal comes in, True Shot Barrage goes through, Destinance connects, but Heaven Time is able to smite that one up and net the first dragon of the game. Over to Team LoLPro, while Richerich actually didn't even get the turret up top. Very low, though, so when they do pick up that one, it'll be that gold shift over right back to Cognitive.
Yeah, the great equalizer would be that turret. It would maintain Cog's advantage, but right now gold is dead even. There is a slight advantage to getting a dragon, which is... You can still always pick up those turrets later. Dragons are only up every 6 minutes, much less reliable to pick them up. At the same time, getting that top turret would give you a lot more map control. Richerich could possibly push in the top lane even more and go for some more offense, let's say, roaming towards mid lane. As that mid turret does get blown up, and I really do mean blown up, it is a Ziggs. Ziggs can really put on the pressure and push.
Yeah, that infuse passive is so strong.
Yeah, he tears through turrets. And of course, he tears through the minions. Jackie going for it, but... Already denied. Can he chase down, though? Has leap available.
All right. Goes into the leap. Does get the slow. He's going to go even further with this one. There is no barrier right now. Zamfir just using that one, trying to turn it around with the auto attacks, and he's able to hold on to his flash this time around. So slowly but surely, he's being able to kite this one out and save his summoner spells one by one in these fights.
Yeah, there was the initial just horrible, horrible situation for Zamf at level 2 when he got forced out, lost flash, lost barrier, but he's been playing very passively, very safely since then, and it's working out. His satchel charge...
Oh, not
amazing.
Again.
Oh, King Showa, King Showa. Oh,
he gets
no,
caught
King
out,
Showa.
Flash forward, gets some shielding, but there's the Tibbers coming in from LOH, and Heaven Time picks up another kill in that lane down bot with that successful man drop. Showa mispositioned and spotted out by that ward, really having a rough time in this bot lane. There's the Mega Inferno Death Bomb. Let's go that out with the True Shot Barrage. It's kind of like Jinx Rocket and Ezreal True Shot Barrage, the combination. Just clears out minions and clears out champions really well.
Unfortunately, could not clear out those minions quite quickly enough. The champions did not really mind that damage all that much. They still take out the bottom turret. Top lane at least had been roaming around there, but no kill on the Mundo, no real pressure. He takes some damage, but he's a Mundo. That was just kind of what he does.
Yeah.
Now, Renekton finishes the Tiamat, has a Negatron cloak. His issue is going to be surviving ganks, because if Jackie roams top lane, if Heaven Time roams top lane, they have ways to keep up with him. They have ways to deal a lot of physical damage, and that Negatron cloak, not all that useful versus really any of the damage those two bring to the table. Hanser himself, he just wants to keep on farming, keep being that beefy, tanky Mundo, and eventually late game, he'll do what he does best, which is sit in team fights and just be there tossing out cleavers.
He's just a damage sink anyway, so...
He doesn't mind, like, we've seen this from LMQ before, it doesn't really matter if Mundo gets bossed around early,
nope.
And actually you can take his top turret, because what's he going to do? Just farm. Like, whatever, alright, I'm Mundo. You kill my turret.
I'm
That's
game.
Unfortunate, but I'm just going to kill all these little, get all these minions up, gather them up, get all this gold, and come back late game and just win anyways.
Teleport actually coming in bot. That's a heavy focus on this one right now. Gets the cleaver out of
Showa.
They catch him out though? The box is popped. No stun comes in from LOH. A ton of damage comes in. A Piltover Peacemaker from Lod gets him his first kill. Finally, after three ganks, he's able to pick up his kill. Pinkward gets killed out there by Nijackie. Looking to go into Zamp. The cocoon connects through the leap. They're going to get the bouncing bomb over the wall, looking for that spiderling, but the team was collapsing from the side of LoLPro, so they do end up backing off. Another Pinkward gets dropped out there, and they are able to clear out the wards. Heaven Time was defending this top lane while his top laner and Haunter was gone and bought. So good job, good coordination to keep that one down. Nothing here, though. Going in onto Nijackie, they force out the jump. He did connect the True Shot Barrage and chunked him away, but it's not enough as Lod picks up a free pink ward. And good rotations coming in from the side of LoLPro right now, even though they're down one turret.
Yeah, they're all around the map. Oh. Even Jackie almost taken down. One more anything should do it, but not quite. Super Mega Inferno Bomb is available, but just not in range, actually. Then Fury would have to move a little bit towards the river to actually land that shot. And at this point, they don't know where Jackie is. Jackie barely surviving this about three times now.
That was really close multiple times. And one more auto attack. He actually would have cinched that kill for Ziploc. So.
I think he thought the red buff might have ticked him down, but was just short. And the flash is at least burned on Jackie. At least got a summoner out of that.
Yeah.
But yeah, the rotation from LoLPro has been very solid. They are giving up CS, though. Mid lane, Ziggs is ahead by 16 CS. Top lane, Renekton's up by 10. And Ezreal's up by 3. It was up by a little bit more, but that's kind of like the bottom lane passive. So it's essentially equal bot lane. But what's been happening is they're putting so much pressure into killing bot lane, but they're not actually denying Ezreal. So Ezreal's still fine, but they're just getting a little bit more gold on Caitlyn, except it's all kills onto King Showa, who, I mean, yeah, you get more gold for your AD carry, that's nice, but he's been dying so much so recently, he's not actually getting enough gold to reset his value at all. He hasn't been getting assists either since that first kill he got down in the bot lane. Or first assist he got in the bot lane. So he's not really resetting in gold.
Oh, no.
And they're about to kill him again.
Oh, the Lantern does spot them out, but it's not in time. Tibbers gets dropped in on top of that one. The Ignite is chasing this one down through the potion, delaying that healing. But this time, he survives, as that Lantern did give him a little bit of a heads up and kept him safe. All right. So Showa, learning from his mistakes there, not face-checking the brush like I would have. And I would have just been one shot, be like, hey, you know what? There's no way they're here. They're not.
That'd be weird for them to camp here. Yeah. That's actually their second time camping in the brush, actually. So, learning from some of the past shenanigans coming out of LoLPro. But King Showa is the focus for LoLPro, and like, it's not the biggest advantage to kill the support a bunch of times, especially if he doesn't start resetting his gold, which I think he might have already ticked down once. But it's not the biggest focus, and it really isn't that important if the support dies a bunch, because Ezreal is still getting quite a bit of farm.
As long as he keeps on farm, it'll be okay. If you're going even with a Caitlyn in lane, you're doing something right. Especially with keeping up in CS. 8 seconds left on the dragon spawner. They're clear out the wards. They're going to know when it comes up. Ziploc is here now. Descendants, not going to be able to connect there. Cocoon not going to connect as well. They get another ward over the side of the wall. Pink ward gets dropped, so they're going to look to clear out this ward possibly, or just keep the dragon out of the pit. And Ziploc may look for the potential steal here. They're both level 10, so it'll be the 50-50 on the smites. And Kha'Zix and Haunts are going in. Looks like they're going to shoot Ziploc as a target. He repels out. Where are they going to go with this? As he does drop down, he cannot click on the Lantern. He will be taken out. Haunts are going to eat the walls up there. The snipe does connect onto Zamfira. He is able to survive that, though, but at the cost of what? It's going to be looking like the Dragon. Rich is there. True Shot Barrage comes through. A lot of bombs. And, Destin is not going to be able to come in as a smite from Najak. Is enough. The man drop coming in ahead of the team, though. He is not able to connect with a stun, though. Satchel Charge does zone away.
Just in case.
They were looking for a flash stun for possibly LOH, but they backed off. Free Dragon for them. That is their second Dragon of the game. So good job by LoLPro.
And there we go. That is actually the rotations you mentioned before. Mundo got there first. Elise was going into the 4v5, and it was a possible good steal. However, LoLPro reacting very appropriately by bursting on the enemy jungler before any chance of steal might have even happened. Mentor goes down as well, as a numbers advantage still in favor of LoLPro. Now up 2k gold. Not the biggest amount, but enough to be worth quite a bit, especially if Jackie's looking for a bait, but there are pings onto him, so this bait, it might just turn around.
Oh, nothing here, gonna get caught out. Can he shift forward? He flashes as well. A three-man Tibbers comes in from LOH, and Nijak, he's gonna jump in and get the resets, looking to see where he can go. He's gonna get burst out of Ignited. That's gonna be enough to take him down, while Ziploc is gonna be the next target. He gets stunned up, he gets blown up, and LOH going big on that Annie. Bloodthirsty support. Gets the double kill and makes it a 3-for-1, trading Nijaki off of that. And Sadism is popped by Haunter. He's just chasing them down and zoning them out with cleavers while the war is cleared out in the pit. And sadly enough, LOD is looking like a support Caitlyn at this point.
That's okay. It's all right to see an Annie farm out of control. I don't think we'll be seeing a DFG this game, but it's okay.
It ain't solo queue. No DFG.
The Talisman of Ascension will be huge for any chase down. That was this weird kind of bait counter bait. Coming out from LoLPro. So they set the trap. They had NY Jackie hiding behind that wall in the mid lane, and he was actually spotted out by a ward. Hmm. So what do they see on the side of Cognitive? We can push out. We can try and set up an ambush for them, except they didn't see the members of LoLPro off on the side coming through the river, and that was the big ink, the big setup. I think LoLPro don't even realize that they were actually spotted out partially for that fight.
Yeah.
But that was a solid initiation. They did lose Jackie in the fight, but a 1-for-3 AOK exchange. And LoLPro, they have a very, very offensive lineup. Like, if they end up in a normal lane situation at all, which does happen every now and then, Heaventime's going to have the ultimate. He's going to always set up ganks. The initiation of Pantheon is so reliable that he will at least get into the fight. It may not be the best setup, but he will get there. that Jackie in the position where he is, 0-1-4, but getting decent farm, and Mundo himself also getting very beefy. It's getting kind of scary, and Pantheon himself has a Negatron Cloak, has a Giant's Belt. A tanky Pantheon is one that deals damage and doesn't die, which is absolutely horrific.
Oh, man. Crit, when you have an ability that just lets you crit whenever they're at a certain HP, that is very strong. And you just throw spears that crit, everything crits afterwards, and you're just set to go. And when he does pick up his Randuin's or, you know, Warmogs or Banshee's Veil, looks like possibly, he's going to be so strong. Not even going for Black Cleaver. Like, normally you'll see a Pantheon who gets ahead build a little bit more damage, maybe a Last Whisper in the Black Cleaver, and then look for his tankiness. But this time around, just going straight for that tank. He trusts in the damage of his Kha'Zix and his Kaylin. As now LOD rotating up. Going to get initiated on here by nothing here. Crit's coming through. A ton of damage comes through. Ziplock, though. Everybody's in the back line as Lod will pick up the kill with that snipe. Admiral Ziplock going to be the next one to go down. Where is he going to repel? Back on LOH. He is ignited. Oh, actually, he lives. The Super Mega Death Bomb. Oh, my God. Super Mega Death Bomb comes in and almost picks up LOH, but he's able to flask up and... Oh, he's got a flask on support, Andy. Well, Nijaki going to get run into here by Zamfira. Here comes the man drop. Going to actually connect on the... Oh, man. It's going to switch over to bot lane. Richie Rich and Haunts are going to go back at it. Well, it looks like actually Zamfira survived. Admiral Zabox still surviving barely with any HP. Haunts going back down to the bot lane using sadism and able to stay up and stay healthy.
The clown card that it was a top lane jungle. I mean, every side thought they had the backup. In the end, it was a 3v2 in favor of LoLPro, and now Richard caught in the bot lane, does have the Dominus available.
He's waiting for Ignite. It's almost up in a couple seconds. He turns around with the Dominus, but it's not gonna be enough.
Haunter can try and kite this out if he lands all his cleavers. Already missed one though, so should be a disengage possibly, or maybe just some sort of weird jungle mishmash warp. Richard, though, if you can stay on Mundo, especially with the Ignite backup, he can definitely kill him. Haunter, though, if he just plays this very backed up kite game, just constantly tosses out cleavers and tries not to let Slice and Dice reset, he will actually survive and eventually kill Richie Rich. It will take a long, long time, though.
Oh,
he walks
right
into him, though.
There it is. The Ignite gets dropped. Is he going to force out a flash? And he is there. Gets the stun. The cleaver to kite this one out. Haunter is going to stay okay. Ziplock is here. Gets the cocoon, but no one else to follow up. Man drop up in about 40 seconds for Heaven Time. So going to see if he can use that for another fight. Haunter sticking around, waiting for that sadism to come back up. There it is. He pops at 69 health a second. Just regenerating like crazy at this point, so waiting to see what they want to do as their next objective. There's 50 seconds left on Dragon. It looks like they're trying to pressure tier 2s as all the outers are gone from the side of Cognitive, and they have one more left in that bot lane for Cognitive to pick up.
Yeah, the objectives left for LoLPro, it's going to be essentially just the inner turrets. Like, that's going to be their most... cannot speak right now, sorry. It's been a long day. But they've got all the outer turrets down. Their next objective focus is going to be going for the inners. And if they want to, they can just set up a Pantheon dive at this point. He is fairly tanky. He doesn't have a lot of armor, though, so that makes his dives riskier.
He's
got his passive. He doesn't have his passive. I'll give him that. So the focus now is either go for the Pantheon dive.
That brush bait.
Or do this. There you go. Go for the brush bait. Go for the traps.
Oh.
If they don't want to fight straight up, their best option will be to set up baits like this. Haunter is caught out, but here comes Jackie.
Showa gonna get blasted over the wall there with that Tibbers and Nijaki just jumping on top of him. Rich gonna be the next one stunned up. He gets taken down by Heaven Time as a nice display of control from the side of LoLPro as they had everything warded up. They cleared everything and they just brush camp like crazy. Showa went to try to ward, but it wasn't enough. There is Super Mega Death Bomb coming in. There is the True Shot Barrage as well. Can they pick up anything off this one? Haunter, with that sadism, still just healing through everything, doing just fine. They might try to pick up LOH or anything like that. Tibbers is sitting over there. Smite comes in from Ziplock, able to pick up that Golem. But with that Smite down, Dragon looks to be the free objective for the side of LoLPro as they want to grab up their third one of this game. Ziplock on the side, though, and everybody else cognizant that it was alive. Let it go towards that Dragon side, but it already fell as LoLPro grabs the third one.
Tibbers revealing himself just to die, unfortunately. Now, 7.7k gold lead in favor of LoLPro. Their team does, I'd say, have a slightly stronger late game in the sense that I like Mundo over Renekton, and I think Pantheon himself can also be effective if he's ahead. So their late game is incredibly solid, but they don't necessarily have a more reliable late game, especially going up against a Ziggs, and Ezreal himself is still very effective just because of his attack speed boost from his passive. So if they want to make this safe, they have to go ahead and stay aggressive, not necessarily rush things, but they want to make sure they're still in control. So brush camps like that, Baron baits, and then anything they can do to start taking down more turrets is going to be their main focus. The dragons are nice. The dragons are just additional gold, though. They're not moving them forward across the map, unless they're baiting cognitive into that position. So now that Baron's kind of been the focus for Akana, they do have it warded up. There is Teleport and Haunter, so he is quintessentially in the area. They can still play aggressively. They just need to make sure that their opponent pressure and cognitive never feels confident in being in the map, in farming up safely.
All right, and as we're looking around for farming safely, Haunter just doing down the bot lane. Nothing here. Going to look to pick up red buff now. He has his Trinity Force making towards that point of the Rune King. He's currently an item behind his opponent in LOD, so having a much better time is him. And Sunfire Cape was completed up for Rich a while ago. He's building that looks like Visage or the Banshee's Veil. Most likely the Visage, though. And they're kind of hovering around towards Baron. Teleport is up for Haunter. They need to send someone to respond to him. Nothing here, not really the best option, but he will be enough as...
He probably won't die.
Yeah, he probably won't die, but they're still trying to hint and possibly bait out a Baron fight here from the side of LoLPro. Zamfira kind of hanging around. Bomb's coming over the wall. Sho and everybody else from Cognitive besides Nothing here hanging out as well.
It's about who makes the first move here.
Uh-oh. Zamfira's going to be the target.
There's the big move.
All right. So Sasha Charge with a Banshee Veil stops that. A nice Lantern from Showa keeps Zamfira alive and away as Haunter goes to proxy farm. Not proxy farm. Kind of dirty farming
cutting.
Yeah, he's pulling the wave. He's doing a little bit of trimming. Mowing away at that. Nothing here, though. Comes in. Sadism is up again for Haunter. Cocoon not going to connect. And they back on out. Hook not going to connect from Showa either. As it looks like they're going to attempt a siege or maybe go back to split pushing and go for Baron. Sadism is activated. LOH looking for a stun. Does get cocooned up underneath that turret. Tanks a few turret shots for his troubles. And a nice little halt from Cognitive to tell LoLPro stop.
Yeah, a good disengage overall. I really love the Banshee's Veil on Heaven Time because I'm 90% sure that is mostly to stop Satchel Charges when he goes for a stun.
Or anything, actually, for that matter. If you come out of the sky and you get stunned, it's just like, damn.
No, yeah, you're dead. But but I feel like he really wants to kill Zamfira, which Zamfira is 001, had a lot of farm. One less than Renekton, actually, so not the most on his team, but he's definitely that really, really obnoxious caster he's trying to kill all game.
OP. Bombs are so strong.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, flash forward on the Zamfira. Box pop to slap Nijackie and LOH, but Nijackie does end up picking up Showa. Gets one reset on the jump, looking for more while Richie Rich is tanking up everybody that he can. He has ignited. LOD does find Zamfira. Gonna throw on the slide. The barrier is forced out there. The Spiderling comes in. Oh, it does actually end up connecting. Bouncing bombs coming through. Nothing here. Is able to get a lot of damage on the Haunter. Flash forward comes in from the Cocoon from Ziploc. Does pick up the kill with that Venomous Bite. They're chasing on the LOH. Now flash forward from Nothing here. Gets the crit. Gets a bunch of damage with that Trinity Force and the red buff slow. And that is going to be a 2-for-none surprise. I don't know. A 2-for-1. Excuse me. Show I did end up dying in that trade. So a nice play by Cognitive to kite it out. That's what their composition needs to do. Need to abuse Ezreal and Ziggs for the maximum effect.
Yeah, Ziggs, he got initiated. He was flash stunned by Heaven Time. The first thing he did, popped on his Satchel Charge, popped on his flash as soon as he landed from the Satchel Charge, got out of the fight, tossed his ultimate. And that's all he needs to do. He needs to be out of the fight, but around as soon as it starts.
Yeah.
To burst people down, to toss out that consistent damage.
He's got Zhonya's now, too.
Oh, yeah.
So you cannot initiate on him.
We saw this come out from probably playing Ziggs. He was able to almost take down entire team.
Oh, whoa.
Like half HP.
Showa, no. No, not again. All right.
It just keeps happening. He's already dead.
He has Splash. Oh, okay. So he couldn't get through that wall.
Why did they keep doing it to him? He just wants to de-ward.
He's just trying to be a support man. Let the guy do his job. But I know the pain all too well. It's okay. But they're going to clear out more wards. They're going to get Baron prepped up again from the side of LoLPro. Respawn timers aren't that long for Sho since he's level 9. And LOH is level 11. So having a really rough time. He's been focused. He's been the center of attention, actually, from the side of LoLPro for most of this game. He's 0-6. He's half of their kills.
And really, like, it's not the biggest shutdown. The rest of his team is still farming decently. It's gotten a little bit better for LoLPro.
It's not even
after
his
they got
fault,
more map
man.
Control.
It's not even his fault. He's trying so hard to
ward. Playing a non-mobile support, which is most of them versus Pantheon.
Yeah.
You're probably going to die. A lot. Unless you start shutting down the Pantheon, which unfortunately for him did not happen.
Unless you run at Pantheon, it's really not his fault. He's just like, I just want a ward, man.
But just want a war. Just want to be in lane without being man dropped on. But can't always ask for that.
It's like there's not even Lucian in the lane or anything. It's like, I'm going to avenge your wife. And it's just like, I'm just going to jump on you.
Yep.
Ruthless.
Let me just go ahead. Just land in lane. The Goomba stomp on you. Rest my team kill you. There
they
you
should
go.
Make a Mario there's skin Pantheon for Pantheon.
That would be pretty nice. I would enjoy that. You can make the Grand Skyfall. Like it'll be a giant pipe coming
a
out
pipe.
Of the ground.
Oh, my God. You just see a pipe come out of nowhere. You're like, what is this? And you're just seeing Mario fall out of the sky and just crush you. Oh, God. Is that what it feels like to be a Koopa?
Every single Koopa experiences that. Every single Koopa you kill. Actually, no. Until you knock them in their shells, then you toss them around to their death.
Oh, Jesus.
Anyhow.
Gruesome.
Ignoring the gruesome violence that is Mario. Like, back to the game. So, it's really been kind of...
Wow, that's good. It's 700 damage to Dragon.
Yeah, that's a crit Dragon Spear. So, Heaven Time hurts. And it's kind of this weird game where there's a lot of damage, a lot of tankiness, a lot of sustain inside of LoLPro. Like, Pantheon is tanky, so is Mundo. And Jackie himself can dive in and out of fights. But it's all about really killing Zamfira. You kill Zamf. You stop the Ziggs damage, you stop the kite potential, and the rest of cognitive gaming will fall. However, if Zamf has been taken down, if they cannot contain that Yordle who does not have Flash but does have Barrier available, they're not going to win fights. And this is where they have to really kind of time their initiations well. Because if they have Heaven Time start off a fight with Pantheon stun, and they don't have Jackie almost landing at the same time as Heaven Time, they're not going to have enough time to burst down Zamfira before he gets a Flash and has to charge away. And most likely survives to toss out more bombs. So they need to really synchronize their initiation or just catch someone else out trying to get someone like, let's say, Ziplock or nothing here and just make it so Zamf has to play a lot more aggressively if a teamfight does break out.
So waiting for that teamfight. Zamfira with blue, though, is a nightmare to push on. Ziggs with blue. Bouncing bombs are on a 3-second cooldown. Just so ridiculously hard to get in on. And Minefield with its max, and you have blue and 30% CDR, it lasts 10 seconds, and the cooldown becomes 10 seconds.
There will always be a minefield.
Yeah, it's really rough to deal with. So, looking to see as they're trying to get wards out here again on the Baron Pit, there is the Oracle's Lens activated, and the little Oracle's effect onto LOH, clearing out the rest of the wards. There's a lot of pink wards coming in. Everyone is buying them at this point and trying to keep space for them, as well as keep more control on this Baron Pit, while a two-man Baron trying to be snuck in here by Nijaki and Heaven Time. Vlad is laying in some damage. They kind of are a little wary of it from the side of Cognitive, but they don't know fully if they're doing it. It looks like
it's going down.
It is going to end up falling, and that's going to be Baron over to the side of LoLPro. Cocoon to stop LOH. Just a man drop coming in the mines to zone away as well. Everybody gets out of there safely from the side of Cognitive, but that is now a Baron up LoLPro, keeping it at a nice pace for their team, as well as just completely shutting out Cognitive's vision.
And that Baron, that was not even a sneaky Baron. They had everybody in the area. They actually made sure it was safe. And it was LoLPro finally making that move because Cognitive was not taking the bait.
Ooh.
Ever.
Uh-oh.
As Ziplock, he's gonna go, he has no mana.
He is able to repel, though. Doesn't cost anything in that spider form. A ton of damage coming in. A beautiful bomb from Ziggs, as well as the True Shot Barrage to follow up, forcing the Flash out. Zamfira going to be that target. He tries the barrier. He tries to get out, but Heaven Time just tanks up the turret, goes in like a man, and it takes him down. But still, it's only a 1-for-none. No, not only a 1-for-none. It's a 1-for-none and a Tier 2 turret in the mid lane, possibly an Inhibitor turret. Everybody kind of a little low. They're going to rely on that Baron regen, as well as Haunter, to soak up most of the damage and keep going for this Inhibitor. Still 30 seconds left on Zamf. He has no ultimate, so there's nothing to really clear out the wave there. Cocoon connects. Are they going to look for anything here? No hook really connected from Showo. Kind of seeing what he wants to do. It does connect onto that Pantheon, but that's not a target he wants to go in on, even though he would like some revenge for those ganks. But still, Haunter tanks it up. LOD gets to lay into the turret, and that is going to be an Inhibitor turret, and most likely Inhibitor looks for the stun on the Ziplock. The Spear is going to follow him through the Lantern, keeps him safe thanks to Showo. Nothing here trying to poke it out, but there it is. The Inhibitor goes down. Haunter gets caught out, stunned up, and flayed backwards. Ignite goes down. He's forced to flash away, and that is still him able to get out of there just fine. Pop Sadism will heal back to full, and nice play by LoLPro, now with a 13,000 gold lead.
I mean, if you look at LoLPro's HP after that fight, a lot of people were low. Same story as before, but Zamfira could not survive this time, could not get away, and without that Ziggs damage, without that Ziggs core to the team, they have no options. They have no reliable damage, no reliable offense in a sense. And it's unfortunate for Cognitive, but the team lineup for LoLPro, when they finally group up, now that they have the Talisman of Ascension, so much tankiness, and they really kind of join together all their CC, Zamfira has no chance to survive. Did not pop the Zonias either that fight, which he did have bought. So that was kind of surprising to see, but, I mean, Ziggs is, the team is too dependent on Ziggs. Every team will have that character that, you know, it's going to be a little bit more dependent. The team will depend on more. Like an AD carry, for example.
Like Yasuo from Cloud9.
Yeah, Yasuo from Cloud9. But the thing is, when you're playing from behind and you're playing something like a squishy mage, a squishy AP mage, it's so much harder to really be around in those team fights long term, which for Ziggs, he is sustained damage. He also has burst, but he's all about the sustained DPS right now.
There's also one more thing they're doing to counter out. They're flashing on him before he can do anything.
They're burning.
And the Pantheon
cooldown.
Sounds like instant. So
right now, like Xamp was able to go ahead and dodge Pantheon stuns when it was just him in a jungle gank. Like that was easy. But he's dodging a Pantheon stun, Mundo
Annie
Cleaver, Annie Tibbers, Jackie's Leap, and then all the follow up damage from that. And you know what, LOD? He can just get an ult off as well. Like he has to dodge everything. And that last fight, he actually got left behind, unfortunately. But it's just, he is fairly slow in the Yordle. Yordle is not a fast champion.
Are any of the Yordles fast? I don't think so. Except for Teemo. Like, maybe
Teemo's pretty speedy, yeah.
But
his base movement speed is actually pretty butt, though.
Yeah. Well, that's why they gave him, you know, a movement speed steroid.
Yeah,
because that's OP.
Quick.
Yeah. So we're going to see the tier 2 up top go down. They're going to rotate towards their inhibitor turret. And actually, there's a Banshee's got picked up for LOH, too. Now they've been looking for any AP, has Distortion Boots, has that flash and a really short cooldown. They're going to look for nothing here, but the Timbers does not connect, and it instantly Showa gets blown up there. They're just diving completely onto this one. Double kill comes in for Nijek. He's able to leap away from the Super Inferno Bomb, and it looks like Ziplock's going to be the target, but this should be game. 40 seconds left on Richie Rich. He's their tankiest member. They're able to lay into these Nexus turrets. Nothing here. Trying to do what he can. There's the man drop coming in, as nothing here is going to be the target, but not going to dive the turret. And there are the Nexus turrets going down. That should be the last one. Nexus turret going to fall. They're going to try to hold this one out from the side cognitive. Ziplock does repel. He's going to get bursted out as soon as he comes back down. Sasha Charge comes through. Zanferi is alive. He's out of mana. And that is going to be game 4 of tonight, going over to cognitive. Not going over to cognitive. Oh my god.